F-22 Raptor is the first fifth-generation fighter aircraft to be developed. The fighter began production from 1996, and the US has 187 F-22 Raptors. Unlike the F-35, which has been developed much after the F-22 and is also a fifth-generation fighter, the F-22 still can't be exported under American federal law. Even a request from Japan, which is a close ally of America, was rejected. This indicates only one thing, that F-22 has many closely guarded secrets that remain classified. But even with what's available in the public domain, we can decipher that F-22 is far ahead of the game compared to any other modern fighter. China's Chengdu J-20, its most advanced fighter jet, is touted to be a fifth-generation fighter. It's manufactured by Chengdu Aerospace Corporation. China has 28 J-20s in limited service. As per reports, combat units began introducing the aircraft in February 2018. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes three reasons why Chinese Chengdu J-20 is no match to American F-22 Raptor. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game, which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One, with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. F-22 Raptor is the first operational aircraft to combine super cruise and super maneuverability. Super cruise is the ability to have sustained supersonic flight without having to use the highly inefficient afterburners. With this, F-22 can intercept targets which subsonic aircraft would lack the speed to pursue, and an afterburner-dependent aircraft would lack the fuel to catch. This is possible due to very powerful dual Pratt & Whitney F-119 PW-100 afterburning turbofan engines. F-22 has a speed of Mach 1.82 during supercruise. Chinese J-20 uses Russian AL-31F engines, which is the predecessor of AL-41F1, and has struggled to make an indigenous engine suitable for a fifth-generation aircraft. The future production version of the J-20 may be powered by the WS-15, a homegrown turbofan engine currently under development, and could enable it with supercruise ability. A fighter jet that can't supercruise is technically not a fifth-generation fighter. It also must be noted here that just designing an engine with supercruise ability is not enough. The engine needs to be reliable. China's been struggling with engine designs in other fighters too, like the J-15. J-15, which is basically an unethical copy of Russian Su-33, has seen several crashes due to issues that are traced back to its engine. The aircraft uses indigenous Shenyang Liming WS-10H engines. China's own media has come down heavily on it. Beijing-based Sina Military Network (SMN) criticized the capabilities of the J-15 as nothing more than a flopping fish, incapable of flying from the Liaoning aircraft carrier with heavy weapons, effectively crippling its attack range and firepower. Radar is like an eye for an aircraft. There was no budget limitation when the AN/APG-77 radar was developed for F-22 Raptor. No compromises were made, and this keeps it at the top even today. The AN/APG-77 radar features a low observable, active aperture, electronically scanned array that can track multiple targets under any weather conditions. It has a range of around 400 kilometers, or around 250 miles, against a 1 square meter target. This radar can also be used for electronic attack by focusing its signals on the enemy to overload their sensors. The radar changes frequencies more than 1,000 times per second, to resist jamming and have low probability of intercept. Low probability of intercept means the enemy radar warning receivers are not able to detect that a radar lock has been achieved against it, and hence opponents have little warning of an impending F-22 attack. With AN/APG-77, F-22 Raptor can gather a lot of data, and some experts have said that the Raptor pilot has God's eye view of the battle space. Raptor is also getting Link 16 installed. With Link 16, military aircraft, as well as ships and ground forces, can exchange their tactical pictures in near real time. Link 16 also supports the exchange of text messages, imagery data, and provides two channels of digital voice, 2.4 kilobits and/or 16 kilobits in any combination. China is still experimenting with different radars, which include the KLJ-7 and more advanced KLJ-7A's prototype, implying that the aircraft still doesn't have such an important aspect sorted out yet. It's well known that Chinese engineering in this field is way less sophisticated than that of the US, and the performance of these radars won't challenge that of the Raptor. Also, it's important to note that having a powerful radar is just one part of the story. Integrating them with other components of the aircraft is very important. Raptor has seen many such upgrades and optimization, which have been incorporated after direct feedback, which were received from mission planners and pilots after the jet's been deployed in real combat. F-22 Raptor is developed from the ground up to be stealthy. F-22 is the stealthiest fighter ever built and has very low RCS, radar cross section, of only 0.0001 square meter. It achieves this due to its structural design as well as the use of radar absorbing materials, RAM. It can't be detected by most radars. Even if some radars are able to detect it, they'll find it very hard to track it and have a radar lock. Viewers may note that to target an aircraft, quality tracking is needed so that the missiles can be guided towards it. Hence, Raptor can strike without the enemy knowing it's there in the first place. Stealth is still very difficult to achieve, and China has a long way to go. Reports have emerged that a Sukhoi Su-30 MKI of the Indian Air Force managed to detect the Chinese Chengdu J-20 jet fighter. The disclosure didn't come from any independent analysts, but from an official source. Indian Air Force Commander Arup Shah said, "The Sukhoi's radar can see them. The new Chinese jets are not so invisible after all. No special technology is required to detect the J-20, as it can be detected by ordinary radar stations." This elevates doubts about J-20, which was already regarded as a decorated 4++ generation fighter by many experts. Stealth is one of the key aspects of a fifth generation fighter, and without it, the fighter can't be deemed as a fifth generation jet at all. China obtained more than 50 terabytes of data from US defense and government networks, notably the F-35 Joint Strike Fighter's stealth, radar, and engine secrets through cyber espionage. The NSA estimated that the Chinese had conducted more than 30,000 cyber attacks as part of the massive defense industrial espionage, and that more than 500 attacks were significant intrusions in the Department of Defense (DOD) systems. More than 1,600 network computers were penetrated, and at least 600,000 user accounts were compromised from the Chinese cyber spying. In all, the NSA concluded that the Chinese compromised key components of the F-35. For example, design details of AN/APG-81 active electronically scanned array radar for the F-35 has been stolen. Importantly, critical aspects of F-35's stealth capability moved to the Chinese hand. The Chinese stole data on the methods used by the turbine to cool gases emitted by F-35's engine, along with leading and trailing edge engine treatments and engine heat reduction data, all key elements of its stealth design. These have helped China to develop J-20. But with copying, you can progress to a certain extent. American R&D effort is way ahead, and this is the reason why China has not been able to match F-22, whose production started more than two decades ago.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.